Hey, people. All right, so we're back on 3D Insight, as I've renamed it. We got some windowception going on here. Good stuff. So we're gonna be picking up right where we left off last time, and gonna do some grouping. Yep. So here's our model. Grouping is kind of a pain, like most rigging stuff is. We've got the bones going on here. We've got to pop up the grouping tool. That's this thing. It's like a square with a dot in the middle. And we've got our messy auto group. Okay. First thing you need to know about grouping. First rule of grouping, there is no grouping. No, I'm just kidding. Let's find our head. There's a head. Okay. So it looks decent enough. That part's all red, as it should be. But it's kinda like jagged and spiky weirdness at the bottom. Okay? When you group, you're going to be clicking and dragging with making a square, and everything in that square is going to turn red if you have this plus sign selected. That means you're adding group. See how I timed that with the music? That's cool. The minus sign means you're taking away red, but basically, you never want to use minus, okay? The problem is, if you're like using the remove thing and you're taking out stuff, if you accidentally take out a tiny little piece that you don't notice, you can lose that little piece and never find it again, and your program will keep telling you, hey, not all parts have been grouped, and you're like, what? I thought everything looks red, but there might be some tiny polygon somewhere that you minused out and are never going to be able to find again. If you add, basically, see the dark here that is unselected is, I'm going to guess that's the neck. See, here's where the neck is. So instead of minusing for the neck, I'm going to add to the head, and it's going to automatically remove these pieces from the neck. If it's on the head, it can't be anywhere else. So when you're grouping, you always add, you never subtract. So I'm going to start and just start. It's not even working. The grouping is really, really weird, really tricky. And sometimes if you're zoomed in too close, it just like won't work for some reason. So there we go. I'm adding, clicking in these little bits. Sometimes it's better to just click rather than drag, because if you drag, you can like catch other pieces that you don't want to. And I've had it where sometimes when I drag, I get like, see, like what's that doing there? That should be the neck. See, that shouldn't be there. That's evil. And that might have been because I like dragged just now and it selected things behind the model where I couldn't even see. Which isn't fair, but that's how it works. See, what the heck is that? That's, ugh, grouping. So you're gonna twist this around. There's a couple pieces there. Ah, see, I just clicked that piece of junk. Okay. So we're gonna click in these pieces to try and make some semblance of normality. But I can't. I feel like these are unselected right here. I'm trying to get them. Come on. Select. Oh, okay. It looks red. Sometimes with the lighting, it can be really annoying because you can't quite tell if it's selected or not. But, you just do your best. And once I select the neck, you'll be able to see. Do, 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 do. Go to the neck, and I can see, oh, look. I need that, I need that. I need whatever these little pieces in here are. Ding, ding, ding. And it looks like this is all good. None of that's selected. We're gonna need that one. Okay. So, things are looking better. No weird jaggedness going on. That's mainly what grouping's all about. You want everything to look pretty even and normal. See, like, I want this all in here. And I want this and this. And I'm wondering, no, I'm gonna think this little part sticking out, I'm thinking is gonna be the chest area. So I'll just leave that and select all up in here. I have like all this sad music playing on my playlist. It's silly. It's not very fitting. Whatever. It's cool. See, now I'm confused because I'm debating. Do I want to select that? Or leave that. Nah. See, that looks weird. Looks weird. Although I could. No. Now what I'm gonna do is go to the chest, grab that one back. Boom. There we go. Okay. So we got that. Once you start getting a part ready, so like, let's go back to the head. I'd say that's basically what I want. So I'm going to weld the group. You always gotta weld it once you finish it. I don't know what the tolerance is, so I just leave it at whatever the default is. Click OK. Boom. And it makes it just like nice and smooth and awesome. So I'll go to the neck. And I say this is ready for welding also. Although what I should do is go back to the head and just check underneath here as best as I can to make sure there's like no pieces of red in weird... No, see what I'm talking about? There's a random red bit right there. So I go back to the neck and I click on that and select that back for the neck. Okay, now I can't quite tell. I have to go back to the head. I thought there might have been one more piece. See, there's something there. This like really dark piece. So I'm gonna go back to the neck. I'm gonna kinda try and get it somewhere in there. Go back to the head. Oh, it appears I got it. It's gone. Then I'm gonna make sure nothing messed up when I dragged that big old square. Yep, looks good. So since I made some changes, I have to weld the head again. Now go to the neck. And I'm thinking it's ready now. So I'm gonna go ahead and weld the neck. Boom. Boom. Sweet. See? Now... Jeez, it's like, where do you even start? There's gonna be so many problems. Grouping is always a major pain. Chest. Okay. So we have a lot of weirdness going on with the chest. Kinda gotta decide what to do with this. I'm thinking... Figured I'm gonna take... I don't know, something happened, it's gone, so I have to... If this happens, where like you accidentally click maybe outside the screen and everything disappears, you just exit out, go back to your grouping, and find whatever body part you're working on, chest. And I think I'm just gonna start filling in these big shoulder bits. Call that part of the chest. I think my abdomen, I'm gonna make this lower bit, so I'm gonna steal this back. I've now selected abdomen, and I'm adding this on. And then you'll see when I hit up the chest again, this is all gonna be gone. Good stuff. So, chest. There we go. See, it's all gone. Right there, and that's problematic, so I'm gonna go abdomen and steal that bit back. Good stuff. Chest. See, now I'm wondering if I want this flappy piece on the back for the chest as well, but probably not necessary, so I'll leave that alone for now. And I want... What do I want? I want ice cream. Freaking love ice cream. Okay. Gonna go there. Here. Yeah. Grouping a model that's all broken apart like this is a little weird, but I'm hoping it's gonna pay off because when we get to the joint parameters, those are super weird and super tricky. So hopefully they'll be a lot better with no armor to interfere. So gonna keep working on this. We're gonna click around. Oh dang it, see, everything's gone again. I did something wrong. I'm gonna go back to the chest. There we go. Yep. So, people. 3D animation takes a lot of work. It's very tedious. It's not something you just, like, pick up and do. It's not someone you just, like, casually ask someone to do for you. Because even if they want to, you're asking for, like, 50 hours of their time or more. Like, this seriously takes ages. I don't know, last night I was animating, I did 80? I want to say, or was it only 60? No, I think I did 80 frames in an hour and a half, which is, like, yeah, really tedious. Usually I can do 100 frames in an hour. But, I don't know, this scene was, like, taking me longer. There was some extra... I don't know, it was a fight scene. Fight scenes really vary when you're working on, like, that fast-paced movement. You never really know how long it's going to take you to get it to look right. But, Yep, so, like, 3D is awesome. You can do anything, and it is, like, super cool to just be able to be like, oh, I want this guy to do this, and I want this environment, and if you can find it or make it, which, like, you can, like, you could technically make anything you want. What is up with this music? Anyway. So, yeah, you can technically make anything, as long as you can learn. And that is, like, super cool. You can make any kind of movie you want. Like, whatever you imagine can be yours. And it is a really freeing, really exciting prospect. It's obvious why so many people love it and, like, want it. But, you know, there's a price to pay for that freedom. You gotta give your time, your dedication, your patience to this very tedious art, and yeah, but for me it's worth it. So for any of you who are considering 3D animation, you know, just consider the effort, but if it's worth it, then do it. You know, I would highly recommend it because it's awesome. It's a great feeling. You get, like, a wonderful sense of accomplishment out of it. You can produce some beautiful stuff, and it's just like you're always learning when you're doing this. You're always figuring out new cool stuff. It's just fun. Just so satisfying. Like, for real. Yeah. I mean, okay. For those of you who are watching this, you can have, like, a little... Oh, should I do this? I don't know. This could be, like... Never mind. Never mind. I just realized. I was thinking about giving you a sneak peek into what I was animating last night, but then I just realized to do that, I would have to open it up in Poser, and I'm already using Poser to rig, so derp, not happening. Yep, you'll see soon, and not really, but you'll see at some point in time that is known as the future. Okay, I'm gonna drag this down and hope I don't mess up anything. Okay. Sweetness. Yep. So, I should talk about something. Well, I could tell you all a story. How would you like that? Stories from Valik Sparks. Story time. Well, I was homeschooled as a young child. I grew up in many different places. My dad flew planes. He flew private planes, like jets owned by companies or individual businessmen and stuff. He was basically a taxi driver for planes. And he was always flying a different plane in a different place. And every time there was a different plane, he moved to the place where the plane was. So the family had to follow him. And so I've lived in many, many places, and I've moved houses about 21 times, including a move to Malaysia for 2.5 years, so that was pretty trippy. But mostly it was around the U.S. It was like Washington, Alaska when I was really young, Colorado, California, Arizona was a big one. Went to a lot of places around there. I spent a lot of time in cars on road trips and stuff, and a lot of my art and even like animation I did in cars, and yeah, lots of crazy stuff. We had like these inverters that would change a cigarette lighter in a car into a power outlet, which is pretty awesome, until they like started exploding and dying. I don't know if that's because I was trying to run 3D programs on this like car inverter, and it was not very happy about that, but I killed all of our inverters, so that sucked. Then I was reduced to like 2 hours of battery life and then boredom. Good times. But where am I going with this? Yep, I've had many exciting adventures in various places, and well, one such adventure was the time when I got a naturopathic treatment called a balloon treatment. Okay, I'm pretty much gonna reveal one of the most horrifying moments in my life to you, so you know, feel good that I'm sharing this with you, because this seriously broke me in more ways than one. So the balloon treatment. My mother is one of them health freaks who, like, is all about the nature and the naturopathic and the alternative medicine and the vitamins and the supplements and the 50 15 pills a day kind of thing. Whatever. So she's like all about that. Not fitting music. Okay. So she learned about this thing called a balloon treatment that is supposed to help out your nasal cavities, right? In your nose, your sinuses, that's what they're called, your sinuses. There's like six, I think, tubes in your nose that are your sinuses. And so this balloon treatment was supposed to open up your sinuses. And apparently when kids are born, they kind of get crushed a lot, and cramped sinuses are the cause of sinus problems and vision problems, like with your eyes and stuff. And I wear glasses, right? I'm like nearsighted. So my mom was like, oh, there's probably a way to fix your nearsightedness. It's probably your cramped nasal cavities. So let's get you balloon treatment and uncramp your nasal cavities. And I was like, okay, sure, it sounds delightful. So, went all up in that naturopathic office, and they were like, okay, basically what we're going to do is stick a balloon up your nose, and then we're gonna blow it up. And I'm like, wait a minute. Can you repeat that? I mean, I wish I hadn't let them do this to me, but I did. I was naive and foolish. I lay down on the table, and this nice lady comes over with a toothpick and a balloon and an air pump, and she comes up to me and uses the toothpickish thing to guide this balloon up my nose and into one of my six sinus cavities, these tubes in my nose. And God, just thinking about it makes me, it's not a good feeling having something go up your nose and down a tube somewhere in your nose. And so this balloon is like a really long balloon. Okay, and it goes up down this tube in your nose, and the end of it is long enough that it's still sticking out your nose. So when she guides it into the tube, basically, dear God, I'm in pain right now thinking about this. Basically what happens is she then fits the air pump onto the side, onto the outside of the balloon, the part still sticking out of your nose. So she fits the air pump onto that, and removes the toothpick, of course, pulls that thing back out. And now you've got a balloon way up your nose, and she sticks an air pump on it, and she blows on the air pump to expand the balloon up your nose, and I swear it was like freaking Saw, like torture going all up in my face. It was horrible. It was literally the worst experience of my life. And she did this to me, good God, like 12 times, twice in each sinus tube, and I felt like my face was exploding. It was horrible. It was literally the worst thing ever. Not even kidding. Ugh. So, after she was done torturing me, and there's like blood coming out of my nose, and one of the times that she did this, when she blew up the balloon, my nasal cavity thing was so tight that the balloon couldn't expand in there, and so instead the air forced its way all the way through the sinus cavity. And you know where those things end up, actually? I didn't even know this until that day. But they end up somewhere in your mouth. There's like holes in the roof of your mouth that lead, I guess this makes sense, but I mean, I just never thought about it. I'm not like a biology major, but there's like the sinuses end in these holes in the roof of your mouth. So this balloon is trying to blow up and it can't. So instead it gets stretched and the air forces it to go all the way out the hole in the roof of my mouth, and this like balloon bubble starts blowing up like a bubblegum ball thing inside my mouth, and it like forces my mouth open, and there's like a balloon blowing up in my mouth that stretches all the way through a tube in my nose and is coming out the front of my nose and blowing up in my mouth. And it was like the trippiest, most horrible thing that's ever happened to me. And I was like, good God, I'm gonna die. And so she had to like stab the balloon in my mouth to make that thing pop. And then it came shooting back through my sinus cavities, whatever, and back out my nose. And I was like, we are done. I was like, no more. My mom was like, oh, I want to take you in for another treatment. You know, you need at least three of these. And I was like, hell no. I was so, so done. So done. Done. It's not even funny. Oh God, that was really horrible. Basically, the worst things that ever happened to me. So, if anyone ever like suggests that you get balloon treatment, run away. Not even kidding. Do it. Run as fast as you can. It is not worth it. Whatever they tell you, it is not worth it. Yeah, so just remembering that event, like, messes me up. It's very uncomfortable. But, you know, you guys deserve to know. You need to know that there are things in this world you stay away from. For real. Yeah, okay, another bit. My brother, who's like, almost 2 years younger than me, also got the nose treatments, and he was like a freaking Frankenstein monster laying on that table. Like, they stuck balloons up his nose and blew him up, and he just like laid there and didn't even flinch. He's just like, oh yeah, whatever. Like, not cool. Not cool. He doesn't have feelings or a soul or something, because that was hell for me, and he's just taken it. And I'm like, really? It's, no, not cool. So I was pretty annoyed by that. Because I was like in so much pain and like writhing and squirming and dying on that table. And he just like lays there like a gargoyle statue. And I'm like, really? No, not fair. But it's over. It's finally over, and I'm never gonna let that happen to me again, because that was horrible. Yep, so here we are, grouping a figure. Hands are really tedious. They're always, like, no matter what you're doing with the hand, it's always obnoxious. Like, whether you're animating it, or you're grouping it, or you're rigging it. It's just like, there's so many little details in hand. It's like, gosh dang it, hands. Why you gotta be like this? But they like this. They so like this. Ah! Okay. So, grouping sometimes is easier, and sometimes is not as easier. I'm thinking I'm gonna fill in more of this thumb here. I'm gonna do that for the hand. Yeah, this is good. Alright. So, all the 3Ds. So, I don't think you guys had any questions. Actually, I said, like, oh, if you have questions, you should ask, and I'll answer them in the next video. I don't think there were any questions, although I feel like I should check really quick while you guys watch. Let me just go to how to internet. Oh my gosh. This is not, I hate the new YouTube massively. Video manager. Okay. What we got? Yeah, nothing. Okay, we're good. No questions. New
Barton wish.
Okay. Yeah. Although there is a trigrams. I put it on his channel too. 3D and slide. Yep, we're all good. We're all good. Okay, so back to grouping. Anyways, yeah, if you guys do have questions, that would be kind of nice, because I'm running out of things to say. But, yep. Grouping can be tricky, especially with the, it, for some reason it like shows all the lighting. Oh, actually, you know what I'm gonna do? Possibly something very intelligent. I'm going to flat shade it, and then see these are different modes for looking at it. You can look at it like a flat line or texture, or cartoon, whatever. So flat shaded makes everything just like pretty bright and nice. So now I'm gonna open up my. Nope, doesn't change anything. Of course, I don't think it does. Maybe it's a little brighter. I don't know. But everything looks really choppy now. No, I'm gonna go back to texture. There we go. Yeah, here we go. Yep. So, this hand is looking decent-ish. But we got some los problemas. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is start going to each bloody finger and fixing it. So, I'm gonna go to L thumb 1, which appears to have no. Oh, there. It does have a little something. Okay. I'm gonna start filling in this a little bit. These are each joint for the finger. We're gonna do the left thumb joint 1, and the left thumb joint 2. So you just kind of like guess where each joint should probably be. Even though it's really dark under here. And also I'm thinking I'm seeing some red there that shouldn't be red. So I'm going to go back to the hand, left hand, and I'm just going to fill this in, go back to the left thumb, yep, no more red, here we go. I really hate it when it's all dark and shady and stuff. It's quite a pain. There we go. You can kind of see what I'm doing-ish. Alright. So we got... we got some pieces up here, which are not supposed to be there. So we're going to go back to the left hand, get these back. Ding, ding. There we go. Health on one. There we are. So, that actually might be filled in. Okay. So that might be good enough for the first thumb joint. So I'm gonna go ahead and weld this now. We can always re-weld it if it needs editing. And then I'm gonna go to thumb two. Start filling in these weird spikes that should not be there. And then flip the camera angle around, which is gonna be all annoying and hard to work with. So, yep, this is grouping. It's very silly. It takes time, probably, yeah, more than, well, I don't know. I was thinking I'd stick around for about an hour, but grouping is pretty straightforward, and I'm kind of running out of things to say. I mean, I could, like, keep telling you random stories, but might as well save those for future sessions. So, I'm probably going to clock out in a couple minutes, but I'll just show you a little bit what I'm doing. I don't think you need any more information. This is pretty simple stuff. Pretty sure you're getting an idea of what grouping is. What we're doing is you're just always using the add tool. You're checking each body part to see what is red, and if it needs more red, then you add that more red. And if it's got red that shouldn't be there, you go to the place that it should be, and you add the red, and then it will take it away from where it does not belong. Yes. So, this right here, the index. Lovely fingers. Lovely, very, very. Okay. Also, the camera angling is really annoying. It just, I don't know. It never really quite moves how you want it to. When you want to flip upside down and stuff, there's just no... Oops, see, now I got myself a problem. I accidentally clicked and dragged. So I'm like, I'm gonna... If I let go of this, it's gonna select something, so I'm just gonna have to deal with it, I guess. Let go. Now I'm like, oh, look at all this junk I selected. Now I have to go back to the hand. But I'm gonna grab this first. Okay. Left hand. Come back. Here we go. Alright. Then we're gonna go to... Oh. We need this. We need that. And something down there. Hmm. paint. Now we're going to go back to index one. Get that part back. You can kind of see sometimes, like, just the shape of the polygons where it seems like it should fit together and all that. Usually the fingers make pretty even rings. This one looks a little funny, but I can't tell if it's just my angle. I'm probably just going to leave it alone for now. Yeah. Don't need to mess with that yet. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and finish up this grouping off of the record, because it's really just the same thing over and over. It's just click and drag, select, get red stuff, and then weld it and move on, and there's nothing more I can really teach you on this, so I'll be back soon and we'll get into joint parameters, which are no easier really. Rigging is certainly a trial in and of itself. It is not the most fun thing ever, but it is a necessary evil, for certain. Just gonna weld that finger. Okay. Well, guys, peace out. Have a good life. I will see you all later. If you have any questions, do hit me up, and I can answer them in future videos. Adios.